The city of Luanda, the capital of Angola, was recently named the most expensive city in the world to live for expatriates, beating out Tokyo, Hong Kong, and Moscow. But Angola also bears the distinction of being the country with the highest child mortality rate in the world. The ties that bind the two? Corruption. Gwen Ifill picks up the story from there.
The West African nation of Angola is a land of contrasts, where the gap between the very rich and the desperately poor is so great that its most vulnerable population, children, are dying every day. Nicholas Kristof, the op-ed columnist for the New York Times, spent 5 years trying to get a visa into Angola to see for himself, and he recently returned with stunning video. He traveled there with video journalist Adam Ellick.
This is the deadliest country in the world for kids, and yet the government has just cut the health budget by 30%. At a sunset dance party in the capital, Luanda, you'd never know there's a health crisis here. And that's a crazy part. This country is actually filthy rich, flush with oil and diamonds. There's so much money here that a one-bedroom apartment downtown can cost $12,000 a month. The real problem is it's just spectacularly corrupt. Officials here spend $50 million a year on luxury cars alone. Judges here get Jaguars to drive, as kids perish at the highest rate in the world. President Jose Dos Santos has ruled for 36 years through a brutal civil war that ended in 2002. He's used the country's oil wealth to enrich his cronies as kids die. But I know the president cares about at least one child. After all, he turned his daughter, Isabel, into Africa's youngest billionaire. Both of them ignored my interview requests. But if you want the government's perspective on how things are going here,
look at this poster.
It's a warning about junk food on the walls of many public hospitals. And it's hanging above kids dying of malnutrition.
Angola, rich oil country, diamonds? How can this be?
The government won't spend the money to make it change.
Stephen Foster is an American missionary surgeon who has worked for 37 years in Angola. He runs a hospital for the poor overlooking the city of Lubango in southwest Angola.
You don't need to make any new discoveries to prevent typhoid fever. You don't need to make any discoveries to provide better nutrition to children.
The reality is that these kids in the hospitals are the lucky ones. 50% of Angolans don't have access to health care at all.
So what I've been seeing in the last few days, kids dying of malaria, of severe acute malnutrition,
yes,
that is the better half of Angolan health care?
I've seen the best. That's what's happening as the best. Yes, exactly.
And Nicholas Kristof joins me now. Those pictures are so tough to look at, and there's so much more online. Nick, of all the places you've traveled, why Angola?
Well, I think it's important to look at child mortality worldwide. There are 6 million kids a year who are dying unnecessarily before the age of five. And Angola is a great place to look at that because this is the highest child mortality rate in the world. And it's a reminder that what we need is not just new bed nets and not just more money, but frankly, improving governance and preventing corruption in some of the countries that are already out there.
What are these children dying of? What are they suffering from?
You know, it's a whole range of things, Gwen. I mean, you have malaria is enormous. It's diarrhea. It's measles. It's things as simple as worms. You know, you can deworm a child for about 5 cents a year. One pill of albendazole will do it. And yet, we saw kids who had so many intestinal parasites that they had blockages in their intestines, and they were anemic as a result.
So these were preventable diseases, everything you're describing here, or at least curable diseases. Why is it that the government is not spending money on its health care?
Because they're not a priority. It's the president's priority is his daughter, and so she does very well. It's his cronies, and so they do very well. And to some degree, it's the stability of the country, and so he pays people off to make sure that they work. And unfortunately for the rest of the world, including the U.S., I mean, our priority is to keep oil flowing out of Angola. It's our oil companies and making sure that they do well. And nobody has really been concerned about the half of Angolans who don't get any health care at all. And in that context, they die at extraordinary rates. One in six Angolan children will die by the age of five.
So, Nick, is this about poverty or is this about corruption or a little bit of both?
In essence, it's really about corruption. I mean, Angola has the wealth as a country. It's got oil, it's got diamonds, and it deploys those natural resources to make sure that the president's daughter can be a billionaire, to make sure that judges get their Jaguars. What it doesn't do is make sure that every child gets a bed net, that every child gets dewormed. And so you have these children dying of completely preventable diseases. One woman in 35 will end up dying in childbirth, completely unnecessarily. You get kids who are not going to school. And so, sure, poverty is a problem, but it's a consequence of the pie being going completely to the elite under President Dos Santos. And the rest of the world, frankly, kind of accepting that situation because, you know, we in the U.S., we're caring about our oil companies. Europe is caring about its oil companies. Nobody is really caring about the disenfranchised people of Angola.
So does the U.S. have a formal bilateral relationship with Angola?
Yeah, we actually have a reasonably friendly relationship with Angola because we have substantial oil interests there. And also, in fairness, Angola has been reasonably helpful in trying to reach more of a peace in Congo. Secretary Kerry has visited Angola. Angolan leaders have come to the U.S. But nobody really talks about these basic issues of governance. And, you know, I've often emphasized that wealthy countries should be more generous in trying to alleviate poverty and donating to alleviate poverty around the world. But Angola is a reminder that it's not just about wealthy countries writing checks. It's also about them holding the feet to the fire of leaders of countries like Angola to make sure that money isn't just stolen by the billions, but actually is deployed in ways that will save lives.
How does Angola rank with other nations of its type, which are rich in natural riches, but poor otherwise?
Angola is one of the least transparent countries in the world, one of the most corrupt countries in the world by various indexes from Transparency International, these kinds of things. And it also is, according to UNICEF, the single country with the very highest child mortality rate in the world. And the idea that Angola, you know, with all of its wealth, has a worse child mortality rate than Niger, than Burkina Faso, than Sierra Leone, is kind of incomprehensible. And that's simply because the leadership doesn't deploy its wealth to make a difference, and in fact is this year cutting its health budget even further.
Well, Nick Kristof, The New York Times, thank you for going where we always can't and bringing us a story.
My pleasure, Gwen.